My dear students, so we saw in our last class introduction to Euclid's geometry. In that, Euclid's assumptions, that is his thoughts, we saw in our last class, that we can say it as axioms. Okay, so as the same postulates also, the assumptions, we can't ask any questions, we can't pose any questions on that, that is based on his thoughts, that we can accept that concepts, that we can say it as postulates and axioms. Okay, so axioms are applied in all the parts of science, okay, including science also, but postulates, that is applying only thing in the geometry, okay, it is based on only on the geometry. Okay, so you all know what is axioms. Okay, so we saw in our lesson 7 axioms. Okay, the things that are same to one another are equal, and if it is subtracted from, the wholes are subtracted from wholes, we can get a whole thing. Okay, the wholes are subtracted, the wholes are subtracted from wholes, we can get a remainders are equal. Okay, so as I said, these are 7 axioms. Okay, in this class let us see postulates. Okay, so what is a postulate? The thing, the concept, we can accept without any questions, that we can say it as postulates. The main thing, postulates are applied only in the geometry. Okay, so the first postulate is a straight line may be drawn from any one point to any other point. Okay, so postulate 1.
Terminal.
line, produce, produces, indefinitely, indefinitely. We cannot say it is till ends here. Okay, so it produced indefinitely, it moves on. Okay, so it moves on. So the terminated line means, we can say in simple words, a line. Okay, a terminated line produces indefinitely. Okay, on both the directions. Understood, children? Next, we move on to postulate 3. Okay, what is postulate 3? What is postulate 3? A circle can be drawn by any radius and any center. A circle can be drawn with any radius and any center. You know a line segment has endpoints. Okay, a line segment has endpoints. Okay, so we can say this is A and B. This is a point A and this is a point B. So this is a line segment. So using this line segment, we can take this line segment as a radius of the circle. We can take this as a radius of the circle. So if you are taking A as center,
we can say it as acute angle. So acute angle
90 degree and less than So obtuse angles are having greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. Okay. So now we have obtuse angles also different measurements. Okay. So now we have right angles are always having 90 degree. So we can say right angles are always 90 degree means that is all the right angles are equal to one another. All the right angles are equal to one another. Okay. Want to postulate 5. Okay, so it is little bit big, but you don't worry, it is very easy compared to all the postulates. Okay, so if a straight line falling on two straight lines, makes the interior angles on the same side. If it taken, together less than two right angles, then the two straight lines meet at indefinite point, meet on that side. Two straight lines produced indefinitely, that meet on the same side of the acute angle. Okay, so same side of the sum of the same side which the sum of the two angles are having less than the two right angles. Okay, see, a straight line falls on two straight lines. So this postulate you can write in your own words also. It should be correct. Okay, so what you are understanding this, you should write in your own words. So if your straight line falls on two straight lines, so one straight line is falls on the another line. So two straight lines we can draw like this. So these two are two straight lines. Okay, it is producing indefinitely on both the sides. Okay, so it is two straight lines produced indefinitely on both the sides. So this is a line L and this is a line M. Okay, so a line L and M are two straight lines. So another line it falls on the two straight lines. This also is a straight line. Okay, and the straight line falls on the two straight lines. Okay, so this is a line N. Okay, a line N falls on the two straight lines L and M. Okay, understood? See here, first concept we are understood. What means that is a straight line falls on two straight lines. A straight line falls on two straight lines. A straight line L falls on two straight lines L and M. Okay. So here we can have a same side of the angles. That is, this line we can say it is a transversal of the two straight lines. A line N is transversal of two straight lines L and M. Okay, understood, children? So this transversal forms an angle on the same side of the transversal. Now we have a left side of the transversal also. We have two angles, that is two interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Two interior angles on the same side of the transversal. That is, this is left side of the transversal line L, and right side also we are having the angles. Okay, so you all know that is two straight lines. A line falls on the two parallel lines. A line falls on the two parallel straight lines. The same side, the interior angles on the same side of the two straight. The interior angles on the same side of the transversal. We have the sum of these two angles are supplementary. Supplementary means 180 degree. That means we can say two right angles. Understood? So if here in this first postulate we can say that is Euclid gave us that is the sum of these two angles are less than two right angles means these two lines meet at any other point. These two lines meet at any other point. We can't say if these two straight lines are meet at a distinct point. Okay, we can't say here it is meet. Okay, so we can't say anywhere. Okay, so it is these two straight lines are intersect at a distinct point. Okay, so this transversal line, a line falls on two straight lines. Okay, that makes the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. That angle, the sum of that two angles are less than two right angles means that side. Okay, that side. If this side is more than 180 degree means we can't say this side it should be meet. So this side we can say it is less than 180 degree means this side, these two straight lines are meet at distinct point. Now we can say in this figure I draw here that is these two lines are like this. Okay, this is like obtuse. Okay, so these two angles are greater than 180 degree. So greater than two right angles. Greater than two right angles. And this side less than two right angles. Okay. So this side, these two lines are meet at a distinct point. Okay. So now you understood the fifth postulate now. Once again I'll say that is what is the fifth postulate? So a straight line falls on two straight lines. The same side of the transversal, angles formed by the same side of the transversal, that the sum of that two angles are less than 180 degree means less than two right angles. Less than two right angles means that side of the straight lines are meet at the distinct point. Okay, see, once again let us read the postulate. If a straight line falls on two straight lines, makes the interior angles on the same side of it taken together less than two right angles, then the two straight lines produced indefinitely and that meet on the same side which the sum of the two angles are having less than two right angles. These two angles are having two less than two right angles, so that lines are produced indefinitely and meet at a distinct point. Okay, now you understood the postulates, five postulates given in your textbook. Okay, next we move on to one example. Okay, so example one. So example one, it is given in your textbook. Okay, so if A, B and C are the points on a straight line, or the points on a line. Points on a line, and B lies in between, and B lies in between A and C. In between A and C. Okay, then prove that. Then prove that AB plus BC equals to AC. Okay, so here it is a line segment given A and C. C is given A, B, and C are the points on a line, and B lies in between A and C. B lies in between A and C. Okay, so AC is a line. AC is a line. Okay, B lies in between these two points. A and C are the endpoints of the given line. So B is the middle. Okay, that is between. B lies in between A and C. Then prove that AB plus BC equals to AC. It is very easy. You all know axioms and you all know postulates also now. Okay, so recount the axioms. Okay, by axiom 4. By axiom 4, you know what is axiom 4 here? The things which are coincide with each other, that is equal. We can say, okay, by axiom 4. By Euclid's axiom 4. What is axiom 4? Things which are coincide with each other. Things which are coincide with each other, that are equal. That things are equal. That things are equal. Okay, so I gave you examples for this. Things which are coincide with each other, that things are equal. Okay, now we can say here. So this is a line segment. Again, we are drawing A and C. Okay, so this is B like this. Okay, now we can say AC also like this. So this is a line segment AC. So in this we know we don't have B. Okay, so this we can say A, B. This line segment we can say AB plus BC. AB plus BC. Okay, so now this we can say it as AC. Okay, so we can draw a line segment. We can draw a line segment AB plus AC, that is AC, and we can draw a line segment AC. So here we can take this as 5 cm, that is 3 plus 2. Okay, I am giving you an example. 3 cm plus 2 cm, we can say it as 3 plus 2, we can have 5 cm. Okay, so here AC we are taking as it is 5 cm. Now we say both are equal. Both are equal. So we can say AB plus BC equals to AC. AB plus BC equals to AB plus BC. Okay,